And then you slap on this motor that just has tremendous torque, and there's no gear changes. So it's just very linear, very smooth power, very natural, and it's quiet. So in my opinion, it was a much more enjoyable driving experience than it was before. So.
What's up, everyone? I'm here with Rocco from Current EV Motors, and he is going to take us through a build I've never actually seen before today. So this is all new. So
yeah.
Rocco, can you?
I'd love to walk you through it.
Awesome. Okay, so, let's do that.
So if you step back for a second here, this is a 1978 Ford F-150. And it's kind of an iconic body style. When you think of truck, you think of this kind of body style. And so when we started out with our vision of doing an EV conversion, we wanted to do a conversion that sort of was the antithesis of an EV, something that didn't quite fit the mold of an EV. And this, in our mind, was kind of that. It also has a lot of design advantages. It's strong. It's got a very strong frame. It's got strong differentials. It's got a strong transfer case. So this can handle the kind of torque that we would be throwing at it with a very high-powered motor. So it's a great starting point. It's got lots of space, very strong frame, very strong chassis. So stepping back, that's kind of what I wanted to mention about it. Why we chose
good bones,
it. Yeah,
if you
got,
will.
Got real good bones.
Beautiful. And
it's
body
a good
style.
Car. It's a good car. It was actually used as a pull vehicle at a marina on the West Coast near Seattle, and so it just pulled boats in and out. Had a little bit of moisture. It sat out in the sun a lot. There's some rust in the bed, but other than that, the body was straight. A couple dings and scratches, some character, but we thought it was a good starting point. So we went with that. The interior was pretty rotted out when we got it, but we went ahead and redid the interior. Got a new cover on the seat, got some new carpet in here, new dash. But other than that, we kind of left it. This is a lot of the stock stuff. And as we did the conversion, we wanted to make sure that the conversion didn't disturb the aesthetic of the interior. We didn't really want to go with the big LED screen or anything like that. The only addition that we really made here was this BMS indicator that looks a lot like an old tachometer and a hot rod.
Yeah.
So we felt like that was appropriate. This is kind of funny. People have been pointing this out to me. I broke one of the switches. So we went with a vice grip.
Tried and true.
This is helping right now. So we did not didn't lose any character with how we're doing it. So
oh man.
Yeah. So it still feels like a 78 truck. You sit in it, you're transported back in time. It's a lot of fun. Still got those smoker windows, so pop those things open, and it's you get a nice breeze
right
on your legs.
Yeah.
And you sit up high. It's just a different way of driving as well, too. A lot of the modern cars, you have kind of the roof line or the window line is about here. Window line's about here, so you get that good kind of up high feel when you're rolling in this thing.
Relax and cruise.
Yeah, yeah. And this is a realization that I came to after we took the gas motor out, is that gas motor generated a lot of heat. Once that was out and you're driving around town, the best analogy I have is kind of like rolling downhill on a bicycle.
Okay.
It's just like the wind in your hair, you're hearing the birds, there's not much noise at all, so it's just a very pleasant experience. But the reason behind the build was more than just, hey, let's do something fun and let's do something cool. The reason behind the build was for us to try and make EV conversions accessible to people. So this very much was a cost savings exercise. And so we built this about 3 years ago. And at the time, low voltage systems were about the most cost effective way that you can do that. And when I say low voltage, I mean something in the ballpark of about 150 volts is what this was designed at. Some of the newer EV conversions are in your 350, 400, and even some in the 800 volt category. So
that's like the newest off
the
line.
Yeah, that's kind of
the
newer type stuff.
The OEMs are putting out the 800 volt architecture.
That's correct. So we had the support of the EV conversion community. That's another nice thing about this industry. It's a very, very supportive community. And what we wanted to do is we wanted to put together a system that would work for this kind of vehicle. So this is a 30 kilowatt hour battery system using repurposed Tesla modules. So there's three Tesla modules on each side, and they power a motor in the rear that delivers about, I'd say about, 400 foot-pounds of torque when it's set up the right way. We've got a slight gearing kind of thing we're working on right now where we're not achieving quite that amount of power, but that's what it's capable of.
Okay.
With this setup.
What motor is that?
It's a Dana SRI 300.
Dana. They're well known in the off-roading world,
they do a lot of axles. They do a lot of powertrain type of work. They're an OEM provider, so they're very, very well known.
I don't think I've ever seen one of their electric motors before.
Yeah, they provide motors through Netgain Motors, and they call them the Hyper 9, and this is called the Hyper 12. But they are Dana Motors.
And interesting.
So, yeah, but they've got the contract for Dana Motors, and so Hunter does a fabulous job. He's great. He's out of the Northeast, and so we worked with him in putting this together. So he was really helpful with that. And we also work with Michael at EV West. He helped to compile some of the components here to help pull this together. And then some folks at, I think this was Thunderstruck. This is the charger for the system.
Onboard charging
onboard
unit.
Onboard charger, yeah. And I think Thunderstruck even has a BMS. We use their BMS system in here as well.
Oh, okay.
And you can see if you look around here, you got some unusual parts. This is actually a radiator from a gaming computer. And so this was the only cooling that the system actually needed. We're cooling down the controller with that, with water, because we're in Texas. We didn't really feel like we needed any glycol in here because we rarely freezes, so we're just using water to cool the inverter right
I'm
now.
I'm glad you said that, because yeah. I've been kind of wildly speculating that kids who've been like building gaming computers and overclocking them, like that's going to be car tuning of the future, and clearly you saw it here first.
Yeah, no, it had the specs we needed, and we said, well, why not? Let's give it a go. We gave it a try, and it kept it cool. So it's been a work. I've been driving this thing for 2.5-3 years now. It's doing just fine.
Do you daily this?
I don't anymore. Okay. I did for about the first year and a half.
Okay.
Our shop is a good distance from my home now, and this is at the shop. We use it for customer drives, things like that. But yeah, if I put the other pack. We have another 30 kilowatt hour pack I could put in the rear and really get that range. It is capable of it. It's just at the moment I'm not using it. But for about a year and a half, it was a great daily driver.
I interrupted you though. You were going around the bay with the different parts.
You'll look at it and you'll say, well, why is there a 12 volt battery in here? That's always the first question somebody that's not an EV converter person. And the answer to that is that this vehicle was wired for 12 volts from the beginning. So it has a wire harness that's in it that runs all of the headlights and the flashers and the interior and all that, all the 12 volt system. And once you have a good DC to DC converter, that allows you to take that voltage off of the higher voltage battery and downgrade it and keep your battery topped off. And so we were able to tap into the existing 12 volt system without having to rewire the whole vehicle.
Kind of functioning like an alternator?
Just fine, without having to tear apart the car.
Great.
We didn't do anything on this truck that's not reversible. Everything's bolt-on. We didn't weld on anything. We didn't cut any sheet metal. So it's all very purist in how we're approaching this and other builds. So, what else to tell you? So, this is a Bosch part. It is a power steering support. So it basically provides pressure to your power steering box. Because in an EV, you don't have the accessory drive coming off the block anymore that would run a pump. So you run this off of the 12-volt system. So this is running all of that. This is the reservoir for it. And because the vehicle is now electric, that electric motor also functions as a regenerator. So it has regen. And very, very strong regen. And once we started driving it, we realized that the power brake system was almost redundant. We didn't really need the power brakes anymore, so we deleted power brakes entirely off of this vehicle, and it's pedaled. That's how strong that regen is. For a 6,000-pound truck, that's saying something. So it's an incredible thing to kind of discover that, and it ended up being a really, really neat exercise in simplicity, and the cost was pretty good. But once we finished this truck, we were already into other things, and so we haven't really taken this to the next level, yet, but we're working on a lot of systems for fleet vehicles, trucks, SUVs, bigger cars like this that have high volumes, because our vision is to support those that are building battery systems like Felton, who can really start buying at very high levels to bring that cost down, develop bolt-on kits for all of the people in the industry so that they can appreciate more margins for their builds. So kind of a thing we're trying to do, but that was the reason we started this company, and that's what we continue to do today.
That's amazing. So, but yeah. If someone wanted this kit,
oh yeah,
they could still,
absolutely.
This is still ready
it's
to
still
go.
It's still relevant, it's still great, it's still
awesome.
good kit, and we know how to, we've done a bunch of these trucks, and so we know how to work on them. They're a great platform to start with, and yeah, I'd love to, if anybody out there wants to reach out to us, please do, currentev.com. I'm Rocco, rocco@currentev.com. And I'd love to chat about any potential build or any kit that anybody wants to buy from us. It'd be great.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Well, before we wrap up, I just have a couple more really quick questions.
Sure.
So we have the battery here.
Yes.
And you're using Thunderstruck BMS.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
The Tesla modules, mm-hmm. the Dana motor. Mm-hmm. Now, how's that motor putting power to the wheels? Are you guys maintaining the transmission at all? Is it a single speed going into it? How are you guys solving that?
That's a good question. We're actually using direct drive. So it's
direct
actually,
drive.
It's bolted directly to the transfer case.
Okay.
Four-wheel drive transfer case.
Is still four-wheel drive?
Still four-wheel drive.
Wow.
Yeah, so you can select between two high, four high, and four low. So you still have that option on this. And the transfer case made for a very nice bolting position, so we bolted right to that and worked quite well. The gearing thing I mentioned before that we're working through is just the relationship between that motor and the transfer case, but we've got a solution for that, so we're really close on it. So but these, again, this was the first build, so
yeah.
you always learn on your first build. But yeah, we also have room for a second pack in the rear, which I can show you.
Yeah.
So you kind of have to tuck under the rear a little bit. And we don't have it in yet, but you can see the brackets that are here. So between here and here,
oh yeah,
a whole another 30 kilowatt hour system will tuck in, and it tucks in real nice and tight, right up to here. Can't even see it when it's in. And so that doubles your range, and it helps with maintaining that voltage for a longer amount of time. So.
And is that water-cooled, plumbed?
It can be.
It can be
because they're Tesla modules.
Right.
And those modules are built that way. So yeah, easily plumbed and cooled, yeah.
When you were doing this build, you probably had an idea of what you were getting into.
Mm-hmm.
Was there anything that just went so well it surprised you?
You know, the best thing about the build were the people that we pulled together around it, all very good at what they did. Right, and I think that was a good move for us to have really qualified people in and around this. If we didn't have those kinds of people around us, this could have gone a much different direction. It took time because we were sort of methodical about it, and we took time to kind of do it that way. But I think your question was, hey, did anything go wrong? I don't know.
There was more that right. Did anything go right?
Yeah.
Because we know something went wrong.
Time was what went wrong. You know, it just took too much time. It just took a lot of time, but it worked out. There were a couple little funny things that happened along the way. We had the transfer case rebuilt at one point and put it in, and I drove it around, put about 30 miles on it, and the guy forgot to put fluid in it. So
I
drove it around with a dry transfer case for a while, and not something you typically want to do, but it's a testament to the Ford engineers because they built these things to be bulletproof. I mean, it'll run without fluid in it. It's crazy. Even with an electric motor spooling it up to 8,000 RPMs, you know? It's like, that's a testament to a good old truck. So,
how did it feel that first drive?
It was awesome. It was awesome because the experience with a truck like this with gas is, it's a lot of jerky motion. It was a manual transmission. It's a lot of this kind of stuff. And it only had 135 horsepower when it was new. So by the time I had it, it probably had less than 100 horsepower, right? And then you slap on this motor that just has tremendous torque, and there's no gear changes. So it's just very linear, very smooth power, very natural, and it's quiet. So in my opinion, it was a much more enjoyable driving experience than it was before. So yeah, it was a lot of fun.
Thank you so much, Rocco. Yeah, I really appreciate you taking
appreciate
us through. And man, what a sweet build.
Yeah, we had fun with it. Good old Gator.